thank you very much. So we have been playing here for quite a few years. So I've been trying to think of a totally different program and tell you different jokes. So here we go. You wouldn't have heard this one before. One of our planes was missing, 2 hours overdue. Yes, one of our planes was missing with all its gallant crew. The radio sets were humming, they were waiting for the word. Then a voice broke through the humming, and this is what they heard. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. With our one motor on, we can still carry on. Coming in on a wing and a prayer. What a show, what a fight. How we really hit our target for tonight. How we sing as we limp through the air. Look below, there's our field over there. With our one motor on, we can still carry on. Jill coming in on a wing and a prayer. A singer at your front door. They have difficulty finding the key and they don't know when to come in.
Very good.
Right.
That's the cleanest joke you've given us.
No, I won't. I've got some other ones, but I won't. Now, this next song that I will sing is called Malayan Moon. Jill is Malaysian. And this song is called Malayan Moon. And it was recorded by Frank Lombard and his Latin American orchestra in Sydney, Australia in 1951.
and subsequently at the end of the 1950s, Malaya became independent and it became Malaysia. And this melody was used as a Malaysian national anthem. So I will sing Malayan Moon as it was in 1951, and then Jill will sing the Malaysian national anthem. Totally different words, but the same melody. Same melody. Jill will sing it in Malaysian, and the name of the national anthem is Negara Ku.
My country.
Hang on. Got to get the right tempo. Treatment. What's the difference between a musician and a large pizza? A large pizza can feed a family of four. Oh dear. Right. We did a gig a couple of weekends ago for Counties Energy in Pukekohe. It was their centennial, and they wanted 1920s music as the people arrived. So I looked up all songs that were composed in the 1920s. One that Jill's going to sing is Who's Sorry Now? Now, Connie Francis made Who's Sorry Now famous in the 1950s, but it was actually composed in the 1920s. In 1923. So here we go, Jill's going to sing Who's Sorry Now? Very quiet, isn't it?
Who's
you want to ask any questions, what rhythm we're using, what key we're playing it in, how many times we've rehearsed it, or anything like that, do not hesitate to ask. We've done that too, sorry now. Here's a song that I make a living by playing music at rest homes and retirement villages, and I ask for requests, and I've noticed that the age of the people in rest homes is getting to my age, and so when I ask for a request, people are not asking for When Irish Eyes Are Smiling, and it's a long way to Tipperary all the time. They're asking for other songs, which I know, but it's not really in my repertoire. So if I kind of know the tune, I'll go away and learn it. And here's one. This is a song that was sung by Robert Palmer, and it's called I'll Be Your Baby Tonight. It was composed by Bob Dylan, and it's also been sung more recently by Norah Jones. Now, does anybody know who is Norah Jones' father?
Mr.
Jones.
Harry
Belafonte.
No.
Mr. Jones.
Not Alan Jones, is it?
No. Ravi Shankar. Yes, correct. It's Ravi Shankar. Yeah. Ravi Shankar is Norah Jones' father. So here we go. And when Robert Palmer, I think he brought out the first version, and he was accompanied by the UB40s. So I'm learning about more modern music that I've never known before. Because my main style of music is Dixieland music and big band swing. So here we go. So I'm using a reggae rhythm, and it's in C major.
How many times have you rehearsed it?
I've sung it at rest homes a few times now. So I've just about got it under my belt. Close your eyes, close the door. You don't have to worry.
Baby.
going to sing a song that was made famous by Patsy Cline and was sung also by Julio Iglesias and was composed by Willie Nelson. Anybody guess what the song might be?
Crazy, isn't it?
Crazy, correct. Yeah.
Where do I pick up my prize?
There you go. These musical jokes, they seem to pick on trombone players and clarinet players and second violinists. How many second violinists does it take to change a light bulb? None, because I can't get that high. Why did the pirate buy a Pavarotti album? Because he loves the high seas. Oh. Right, what we're going to do? Oh, that's right. Stick to the music?
Yes. That mine I would hold you.
lovely there, Jill. Another song that was surprisingly composed in the 1920s was Carina, Carina. And when I listened to a recording in the 1920s, they did it, it was a country song. So it was a bit like this. Jill? When we play it now, I hadn't heard that before, because when we've normally done it, we play it like this. Soprano sing the scale. Do, re, mi, 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 mi.
What does that mean?
They're very egotistical. C, middle C, E flat, and G walk into a bar. The barman says, sorry, I don't serve minors.
All right.
It's a parody on Are You Lonesome Tonight?
Oh, yeah. This is a funny one. Is it the funny one Elvis did?
Yeah.
Listen to the words.
Are You Lonesome Tonight, and they were on the internet.
I can see why you like them.
Right, paper doll.
Oh, that's
your own. I'm through with all of them, I'll never fall again. Say, boy, what you gonna do? We're now going to sing a Freddie Fender song. Before the next teardrop falls. And the rhythm that I'm using for this is Modern Country Ballad 2.
Every
Okay. I've just thought of this song, or tune. It's called The Flight of the Bumblebee.
Oh,
oh dear. What's he been drinking? Finish off with another song in harmony.
Iceman.
Yeah. Jill goes back to Malaysia in a month's time. Jill isn't here all the time. We've been together 20 years, and probably the reason that we have been together 20 years is that Jill goes back to Malaysia and has a break from me. Anyway, before Jill, I won't tell you the ages, but Jill is actually older than me. But before Jill came back this time, I was playing at a retirement village, and a lady came up to me and said, "Joe, when's your daughter coming back to sing with you?" And we were at another place a while ago when Jill was here, and I was playing something on the keyboard, and a gentleman came up to Jill and said, "You know, your grandfather's very good on the music."
She didn't wear her glasses.
Anyway, this piece of music needs no introduction.
Yeah, we can all sing together.